Welcome to MTV's News Update June 16, 2020 edition. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we're tracking this evening. GCOM paves the way for PPP to be declared winners of 2020 elections. Justice Singh says GCOM has no power to annul an election. Guyanese protest in front Guyanese Critics House following his racial insensitive remarks. Dr. Ali ready to take the reins of the country. Carter Center supports report by CARICOM Observer team. And in sport, Guyana's Ashmead net signed by Leeward Islands Hurricanes. More coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1 year factory warranty along with our after sale service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Now using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Start feeling good again with Probiotic XL. Probiotic XL contains a proprietary formula of 10 of the most important probiotics that have been researched and developed to help your body get rid of what's bad for it and help promote what makes you feel good. If leading a healthy life and enjoying every day is something you want to do, then Probiotic XL is for you.
Welcome back. Now for the news in details. Chairperson of the Guyana Elections Commission today refused to annul the elections and has asked the Chief Elections Officer to prepare his report to declare the PPPC the winner of the 2020 elections.
After 15 weeks of a stalemate over the 2020 elections, which ran off on March 2, the dust in the air is starting to settle. Today, Chairperson of the Guyana Elections Commission, retired Justice Claudette Singh, told the Chief Elections Officer, Keith Lowenfield, to prepare his report. This followed a meeting with the commissioners today to decide what to do with the data from the recount. The data will now be used. Following the meeting, GCOM Chairperson said the commission does not have the powers of a court of law to examine and re-examine witnesses or to procure official documents to determine the truth of the allegations of fraud. She underscored that the Constitution confers on the High Court the exclusive jurisdiction to determine the validity of an election. Justice Singh also noted that the Commission cannot annul an election since no specific power was conferred on it. As such, a declaration will be made from the recount of figures that showed the PPP gaining more votes in the elections. Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
Guyanese of African descent today protested in front of the house of the self-proclaimed Guyanese critic following his insensitive remarks against Guyanese of African descent, Christians, as well as Indo-Guyanese.
Mikhail Rodrigues, who proclaimed himself the Guyanese critic yesterday, came in for heavy criticism after he went down a path insulting the intelligence of Guyanese of African descent, Christians, as well as Indo-Guyanese. Rodrigues made the severe racist remarks mainly against Afro-Guyanese, during his daily live video on Facebook. Majority of the viewers were disgusted and became enraged at the insensitive comments made by the social media personality. He sought to give an apology, claiming his words were used out of context, but Guyanese did not believe the apology to be sincere. As such, they marched in front of his house this morning, chastising him for his utterances.
Who is a racist? Who is a racist? Black lives matter in Guyana too. I can read and I come back. You are a racist.
A petition has since been launched for the removal of his Facebook page. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
The Carter Center is supporting the findings of the report from the CARICOM Observer team and is calling for a winner to be declared.
In a statement issued today, the Carter Center welcomed the CARICOM team of scrutineers' report, which states the recount results are acceptable, and it provides the basis for a winner to be declared from the March 2 elections. In the Chief Elections Officer's report, it was revealed that the People's Progressive Party Civic had won the March 2 elections. The Carter Center reminded that the electoral preparations, voting and counting procedures met international standards, but the March tabulation process for Region 4 generated results that were not credible. It was revealed during the recount that numbers were heavily inflated in favor of the coalition by the returning officer of Region 4. The statement urged Guyanese to prioritize efforts to strengthen Guyana's democracy. Luan Williams, reporting for MTV's News Update.
Following the report of CARICOM giving credence to the data recorded in the elections recount, presidential candidate of the People's Progressive Party, Dr. Irfan Ali, is hoping that good sense prevail to allow the country to develop. He noted the report is clear that the recount was transparent and credible. The Commonwealth has added its voice to the call for the recognition of the results from the national recount.
Secretary General of the Commonwealth, Baroness Patricia Scotland, said the results from the national recount should be used to declare a winner of the March 2 elections. She said the CARICOM Observer report is clear that the recount results are completely acceptable. The Commonwealth expects President David Granger and opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo to honor their commitment to respect and adhere to the results from the national recount. The Caribbean Community, Organization of American States, the incoming chairman of the Caribbean Community, United States, Britain, Canada, and the European Union have all called for the recount results to be used to declare the results of the March 2 elections. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
Still ahead, ERC urges peace as country awaits elections results, and ExxonMobil reduces oil production offshore Guyana.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step 1, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step 2, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step 3, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step 4, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
The Ethnic Relations Commission is appealing for peace as the Ghana Elections Commission prepares to make its decision on the March 2, 2020 general and regional elections.
The Ethnic Relations Commission has called for all Guyanese to remain calm and to demonstrate a profound sense of tolerance and respect as the nation awaits a declaration from the Ghana Elections Commission. The ERC in a statement said, it is mindful of the discontent of citizens as the wait for the declaration has inevitably precipitated and urge that the results, when announced, be respected. The commission said it is paramount for all political leaders and civil society to act in a responsible manner in an effort to safeguard the interests of Guyana. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
ExxonMobil has reduced its production of oil offshore Guyana in order to cut down on flaring.
ExxonMobil has reportedly reduced its production from 80,000 barrels of oil per day to between 25,000 and 30,000 barrels per day. This was decided after the company had met with the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA. The EPA had stated they cannot exceed the 15 million cubic per feet day limit. Just recently, it was reported that ExxonMobil had flared over 2 billion cubic feet of natural gas offshore Guyana. In addition, the Center for International Environmental Law, CIEL, has issued a statement in which it urged the company to stop flaring gas offshore Guyana. The statement had claimed the flaring exceeded the levels approved by the government, the level that puts Guyana among the top 10 gas flaring countries in the world. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
The government is seeking shops and supermarkets to supply dry and fresh ration as part of relief efforts for citizens affected by COVID-19.
The government is inviting suppliers to indicate their interest in providing bottled and canned food products, as well as dry and fresh ration. These goods will be given to citizens who became vulnerable due to the pandemic. Interested suppliers are invited to fill out a form which can be uplifted at the Civil Defense Commission office or submit online between 9 hours to 15 hours from June 11 to 17. Suppliers who are selected will have to ensure their business has adequate space that is in compliance with the Public Health Ministry's social distancing guidelines, as well as the establishment of sanitation facilities. Proof of business registration and recent National Insurance Scheme and Guyana Revenue Authority compliances are also required. In order to qualify for public assistance, individuals must submit a form to the Ministry of Social Protection, proving that they fit the criteria required by the ministry and once deemed eligible will be the recipient of the relief vouchers. Eligible persons are those that fit the following criteria. Individuals or households currently benefiting from public assistance provided by the Ministry of Social Protection. Individuals or households who applied for public assistance and are awaiting a response from the Ministry of Social Protection. Individuals or households who suffered a loss of income due to COVID-19. And households headed by senior citizens or persons with disabilities. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Riffitt.
More news still ahead. Stay tuned.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full-body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. Our wall and ceiling gypsum system, it's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Cherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, Feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Gaffords, manufacturers of the perfect concrete hollow block in sizes 4 inches and 6 inches, certified by the Ghana National Bureau of Standards and hydraulically tested by the University of Guyana to 2,000 pounds per square inch. Pallet packed and shrink wrapped for easy transportation too. So get your supplies of the best quality made concrete hollow blocks in Guyana and also get a 12.5% discount. For superior service, quality and competitive prices, visit Gaffords Mega Complex at Macdu and our outlets at Rose Hall, Kanji, Benefo Acting, Memes, Land of Canaan, and Perica.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
And now for your sport news. Cricket Australia chairman Earl Eddings believes it is unlikely and unrealistic that the men's T20 World Cup will bowl off as scheduled this year.
Eddings feels time is running out and pointed out it was very, very difficult to stage the tournament. The tournament set between October 18 and November 15 in Australia is being deliberated by the ICC board, which deferred to make the final call. The ICC has continued to remain optimistic despite the growing likelihood of the tournament being postponed. ICC Chief Executive Manu Sawhney said there was only one chance to make the decision and it was needed to be the right one. Eddings said it was a bit of a moving feast at the moment and he would say it is unlikely. He added, while it has not been formally called off this year or postponed, trying to get all 16 participating countries into Australia is unrealistic. Eddings informed they have put forward a number of different options to the ICC. This is the second time in the last month Eddings has asked the ICC to consider postponing the T20 World Cup. He suggested Australia host in October-November 2021 and India stage in 2022. Doing that, Eddings said, would financially help all the member countries. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sport Update.
Discussions have started about fans attending Premier League matches again, says Chief Executive Richard Masters. The English top flight restarts tomorrow after a 100-day break because of the coronavirus pandemic, with fixtures played behind closed doors. Masters did not put a time frame on a return of fans to stadiums, but said talks had begun with the government. He said the Premier League is back, but it will not be fully back until they get those fans back inside the stadium. The league returns with Aston Villa against Sheffield United on tomorrow, before Manchester City host Arsenal. There will then be another 90 games to fit into a compressed schedule. Masters also pleaded with fans not to congregate outside stadiums. Players' name will be replaced on the back of their shirts with Black Lives Matter for the first 12 matches of the restarted season, as part of the league's response to the anti-racism protests seen globally since the death of George Floyd. Masters backed the statements, with the Premier League supporting any player who chooses to take a knee before or during matches. The Ghana Jaguars yesterday signed former West Indies under-19 wicketkeeper batsman Tevin Imlach, while Ashmead Ned was snatched up by the Leeward Islands Hurricanes.
Cricket West Indies hosted the 2020-2021 Professional Players Draft for the Super 50 Cup and West Indies Championship via Zoom meeting. Each franchise made 2 picks to bring their squad of players to 15. Previously, the franchises announced their 13 protected players ahead of the draft. The Jaguars have contracted Kevin Sinclair, Niall Smith and Akshaya Prasad. Clinton Pestano and Devendra Bishu battling knee injuries, and Romario Shepherd moving up the CWI retained players contract will be absent. Jamaican all-rounder Ramal Lewis and Bayesian Raymond Reefer are the 2 outside home territory players for the Jaguars. Meanwhile, Ned is the lone Guyanese signed as an outside home territory player for the Hurricanes. The full Guyana Jaguar squad reads Kevin Sinclair, Tejnarine Chanderpaul, Chanderpaul Hemraj, Virsami Permol, Tevin Imlak, Ramal Lewis, Akshaya Prasad, Niall Smith, Vishal Singh, Christopher Barnwell, Anthony Bramble, Gudakesh Moti, Raymond Reefer, Keon Joseph, and Leon Johnson. Chelsea Lee, reporter for MTV. Sports Update.
Archery Guyana joined 20 other countries yesterday in stage 11 of an international remote archery competition in keeping with the WHO PAHO COVID-19 measures.
Continue to display resilience and adaptation to the discipline. Competitor Robert Singh scored a 539 of 720 in 7th place during the 30-meter recurve bow category. Meanwhile, newcomer Samir Duncan recorded a 379 of 730 in 2nd place in the 25-meter recurve category. Wynette Lawrence scored a 642 of 720 in 9th during the compound bow category. Singh informed at this standard of international competitions, it requires his improvement for consistent high scores. At the same time, Duncan said as this was her first online international competition, she was not prepared for the level of those in other countries. Competition continues next on June 21 with Stage 12 as Archery Guyana urges its archers with access to ranges or home facilities to participate. All archers are mandated to observe their national health and safety requirements of the PAHO WHO guidelines for prevention of COVID-19. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell says he would encourage a team to sign former San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick. Kaepernick began kneeling during the U.S. national anthem in 2016 in a protest against racial injustice and has been a free agent since 2017. The National Football League banned players from protesting in such a way but now says it was wrong to do so. Goodell said he will support a club wishing to sign Kaepernick. Current NFL stars, including Patrick Mahomes and Odell Beckham Jr., had called on the league to condemn racism and the systemic oppression of African people. The NFL has since pledged $250 million over a 10-year period to help combat systemic racism in the United States and says the fund will support the battle against the ongoing and historic injustices faced by African Americans. And that brings us to the end of Sport Update. More after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall. ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. GCOM paves the way for PPP to be declared winners of 2020 elections. Justice Singh says GCOM has no power to annul an election. Guyanese protest in front Guyanese critic's house following his racial insensitive remarks. Dr. Ali ready to take the reins of the country. Carter Center supports report by CARICOM Observer team. And in sport, Guyana's Ashmead net signed by Leeward Islands Hurricanes. Catch our rebroadcasts at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Ashley Scotland. Good night.